Hello students, let's start to solve some numerical problem based on the chapter that we have ended yesterday. So as in the chapter electromagnetic induction, up to now we have just discussed some of the topics like self inductance, mutual inductance and how to produce the EMF, and in first concept we have studied for the Faraday law of electromagnetic induction. So as yesterday's lot of conceptual problems we have discussed, and that is I think that's all clear to you. Then let's start to solve some numerical problem, and I will just take a random numerical problem from all the topics that we have discussed on the chapter. So here the first numerical problem is given to us, that is a conducting circular loop is placed in a uniform transverse magnetic field of 0.02 tesla. So somehow the radius of the loop begins to decrease at a constant speed of 1 mm per second. So find the EMF induced in the loop at the instant when the radius is 2 cm. So here we have given the data that let me write that first, then after I will just discuss the question that is given to us. So here in the data it is given that we have the magnetic field, its value is 0.02 tesla here, and it is given that we have a circular loop, and this circular loop we have put this loop in transverse magnetic field. So first, the transverse word means we have kept the loop in such a manner that its area is or area vector that you are seeing for the loop, that is perpendicular to the magnetic field. So the loop is perpendicular to the magnetic field. So obviously, like if suppose in this direction we have the magnetic field and we have kept our loop in such a way, like this is our loop and this is the direction of the magnetic field. So now if you will just draw the area vector here, so this area vector will be also in the direction of the magnetic field. So for this condition, as theta here, this will be equal to 0 degree. So as theta is 0, then we can calculate the phi here. So obviously the flux will be equal to BA cos theta. So here theta is equal to 0, means we will get some of the flux here. Now it is saying that the loop radius start to decrease now. So it means that we are changing the area of the loop now. So whenever area of the loop will change, then you know that the flux linked with the coil, that will change, and due to the flux linked with the coil, change in flux linked with the coil, an electromagnetic induction effect you will get, means induced EMF and current you will get in the coil. So here we have to find out the value of induced EMF whenever the radius is contracted to 2 centimeter. So we suppose that at any instant t, the radius of the loop was small r at some t here, then that time the area of the loop will be here area as it is pi r square. Clear? So the circular loop is given to us, then its area is at any time r, radius is at any time r, then area will be pi r square. Now we can calculate phi at that time. So phi at that time is given by B into A. As theta is 0, then B A cos theta, from there we can calculate, like write down this one. So finally it will be equal to B into pi r square now. Now as this radius r is changing, and due to that change in radius we are getting the change in flux and induced EMF. So according to the Faraday law of electromagnetic induction, the magnitude of induced EMF is given by rate of change of magnetic flux. So here the magnetic flux, it is B into pi r square that we have calculated just now. And here in this equation you can see that this B, as we have taken it uniform magnetic field, this is constant, pi is already constant, then the variable term is r square. So we can take B and pi outside the equation, and finally we can just differentiate r square. So differentiation of r square will be 2r dr by dt. So now in our question, this value is given with time t, how the radius is changing. So dr by dt, its value is given to us, that is equal to 1 mm per second. So we can convert it in meter per second. So mm can be converted in meter by multiplying 10 power minus 3. So this will be 10^-3 meter per second. At this instant t, when we are seeing this contraction, r is given to us, that is 2 centimeter. So for this we can also convert it into meter, so it will be 2 × 10^-2 meter. Now we can put all the values here and we can calculate what is the magnitude of the induced EMF for this kind of change in the radius of the loop here. So let's calculate it. So finally we have the induced EMF value. This is equal to B pi 2 times R into dr by dt, and value of B is given 0.02, value of pi you know already, that is 3.14, and here 2, R is given to us, this is 2 × 10^-2, and finally here this is given to us, that is dr by dt, its value is 10^-3. Whenever you will solve all these values, then you can find out what is the final voltage that we are getting. So this is equal to 2.5 microvolt. So this is our answer for this question of the induced EMF that is produced due to change in area of the coil here. Now second question, let's see that. Again second question I have taken from the same Mostel EMF topic. So it is saying that a 0.5 meter long metal rod PQ completes the circuit as shown in figure. So let's see the figure first. So here a uniform magnetic field that and its direction is perpendicular to the plane in outward direction, it is given to us. And in this uniform magnetic field, a loop is given to us, and here PQ, this is the movable arm, is given to us, and radius of this one, resistance of this wire is given, that is 3 ohm. This is our SR. Now let's read the question. That is, next question is given to us, that is the area of the circuit is perpendicular to the magnetic field of flux density 0.5 tesla. If the resistance of the total circuit is 3 ohm, calculate the force needed to move the rod in the direction as indicated with a constant speed of 2 meter per second. So here in this question we have a loop, total PQRS loop, in which 3 ohm resistor we have connected with this loop, and this is kept in a perpendicular uniform magnetic field. And here one more thing, if you will take see the area vector of this one, it is given that area of the loop, area of loop means here if you will see the loop that is in the plane of this paper, but magnetic field is perpendicular to the plane of paper. But whenever you will draw the area vector, that is you know already, that is the in the normal direction to the plane of the loop any. So here plane of the loop is this one, so area vector will be also perpendicular to this, and this is the direction of magnetic field, means the angle between magnetic field and the area vector, that is again zero here. So theta, that we can write, this is zero. So first our deduction from the question is this one. Next it is given that this in this whole of the loop, this PQ arm that you are seeing, this is only the movable arm, and it is moving with this velocity v. Then we have to find out what is the force that is needed to move this arm from in this magnetic field here, so that magnetic flux can change. You can calculate induced EMF, but here you don't have to calculate the rest of the things, only you have to find out what will be the value of the force here. So as you know that here in this case, this is the case of actually Mostel EMF. For the Mostel EMF concept, we have utilized such kind of U-shaped rail here, over which we are just joining some of the conducting wire, and this conducting wire is free to move along this length. And in this whole of the process, if this arm will be moved, then area of the loop will change, and whenever area of loop will change, then flux link with it, that will change, and according to that you can calculate the EMF of the induced EMF that is generated here. So induced EMF formula, if you I will use it directly, then this is given by B L into V, where L is the length of the this movable arm PQ is given to us, B velocity that through which it is moving, and in B magnetic field it is situated here. So it will induce this EMF in this PQRS rectangular loop that you are seeing. Now you can calculate the current from here. So as it is given that the here 3 ohm resistor we have connected, then I can be given by voltage per unit resistance. So here VLV upon 3. So here let's put the value of V from the data. So in our data it is given that the value of V is 0.15 Tesla. Value of L is given 0.5 meter long this wire is, and resistance is already given to 3. One more thing is given to us, the velocity through which it is moving and for which we have to calculate the force that is needed to move it. This is 2 meter per second. So here if we will put all the values, then this is 0.15, L is 0.5, V is 2 and this is 0.3. And if you will solve, this will be equal to 0.05 ampere. So this is the induced current inside this loop here. Now we have to find out the force, and you know that whenever we are putting any conductor in external magnetic field, then that conductor experiences a force, and due to that force that conductor start to rotate around its axis, and that's why we are getting the concept of torque. And later we have utilized that concept in galvanometer. In the chapter magnetic effect of current we have studied it already. So here we can utilize that concept from there, the Lorentz force concept on any conductor. So that this is the conductor of L length, this is kept in magnetic field B, and this is moving with some velocity V here. So here and I current is induces due to this movement here. So as we can find out the force by IVL sin theta. So this is the Lorentz force that will be experienced by the rod, so that it will move with some velocity V here. So this is the force that we had to derive and we have to calculate here. So to calculate it, first we need the theta here. Again, if you will see the orientation, so this theta is angle between current element and magnetic field. So as current element, if you will see, so its direction will be, if current is flowing in this one, so as this current is in this direction and magnetic field is in this direction, so magnetic field is perpendicular to the current element here. It means theta is 90 we have for this case. So as sin theta it is sin 90, then its value will be equal to 1. So we can just remove sin theta from here. Now we can put all the values that we have calculated. So I we have that is 0.05. Now we have given already the values, that is V 0.15 and L is given to us, that is 0.5. So here if you will multiply all these factors, then we will find out the force that is needed to move this arm PQ with some velocity V is equal to 2 meter per second. So this Newton force we are needed for this work. So such kind of question from the motional EMF can be asked to you. Now in next question, a derivative question we have. You have to derive an expression for the situation that is given to us. So in the question, situation is given, we have a figure that is showing a rectangular conducting loop PQRS in which the area PQ, the arm PQ is free to move. So let's first make this loop here that is given to us. So here we have again the magnetic field that is given to perpendicular to the plane of paper in outward direction, and in which loop PQRS is given to us, and in this loop PQRS this is P, this is Q, we have this is R, this is S. Here you can see that in this loop we have four arms PQ, SP, SR and RQ. And in whole of the arm, only PQ arm is movable here. Now let's read the question. is given a uniform magnetic field acts in the direction perpendicular to the plane of the loop. So arm PQ is moved with a velocity V towards the arm RS. So this is the arm RS and this PQ is moving with some velocity V towards this one. Next it is given, assuming that the arm QR, SP and RS have negligible resistance and the movable arm PQ has resistance capital R. So here next one is, thing is given, we have three arms SP, SR and RQ. In these arms resistance is negligible, means if resistance is negligible here, whenever current will be induced EMF we will get, then due to that induced EMF here current we will not get for this one, because whenever resistance is not present we cannot obtain any current from that conductor. So here the current will be current will flow from only this conductor and this part of the conductor, that is PQ, for which it is given the resistance, that is capital R. And if suppose we have it is given already the resistance for these all arms, then we have to take into consideration for our question all these arms there. Next here question now, let's see, that is obtain the expression for first the current in the loop, second the force, and third the power required to move the arm PQ. So here we have to derive expression for force, current and power in this kind of loop. So this question we have derived already while just discussing for the motional EMF, but again as the some of the situations are included here, there already that limitations we have taken, that a U-shaped rail we have taken, and for which this U-shaped rail was fixed, only this arm PQ was free to move. So this is the same situation that we are taking again here. So here as PQ arm is free to move, then if it at any time if it will move to suppose this point, and for which this is equal to x this distance and its length is given, that is L, then that time its area will be equal to L into x, because it is rectangular loop, and as x is changing with time continuously due to the movement of this arm PQ, so area will change continuously, and due to change in area phi will change. So whenever flux will change, then due to change in flux we will get some of the induced EMF here, and if you will get induced EMF, then by the help of resistance you can obtain current from there. So let's solve the first question here. So here are two methods to understand such kind of questions. First, as I've told you, we can derive the expression by using Faraday concept. Second, by using the Lorentz concept. So here as I have to derive the force also, then I will go to the Lorentz concept here. So as in the case of Lorentz concept, we are utilizing the concept of the Lorentz force. And first, before utilizing the Lorentz force, as you know that any conductor is made up of the large number of electrons, and whenever here we will put any charge that is moving with some velocity V in external magnetic field, then Lorentz concept tells us that that charge will start to feel some force, and due to that force that will start to change its direction, and for which we have seen already circular and helical motion, linear motion for any charge particle in external field. So that force will be equal to QVB sine theta here. So this is the Lorentz force experienced by the particle here, that is equal to QVB sine theta. Next, as this force is experienced by the any electron of the conductor, then we can see that the direction of the force here. So as now you can utilize the concept for the Fleming's right hand rule here. So again, to understand the Fleming's right hand rule, let's put your hand in such a form, for which here if you will see this thumb that is representing the magnetic field, here middle finger that is representing the direction of motion, then index finger it is representing the direction of Lorentz force. So it means that the Lorentz force here that will act on the electron in upward direction. So electron will start to move in upward direction, and due to the movement of electrons in upward direction, they will start to accumulate at this point or end Q here. But you know that electrons are already negatively charged particle, and negative charged particle that will produce some electric field around it. So due to the presence of electric field E, the next electron will feel electrostatic repulsion there, and it will start to do some work due to that. So here the force that the second electron will experience in electric field of the first electron, that is equal to Q into E. So here continuously due to the Lorentz force, it will the electrons will start to move towards this arm, but at the same time electrostatic force repulsion between electrons will also work there. So at the instant when this Fm will be equal to this Fe, the accumulation of the electrons will stop, because this force will be counterbalanced by the electrostatic force. No electron will move further, so no accumulation will be there. But at that time, if you will see this arm Q, so here number of electrons are accumulated, means negative charge particle efficiency is here, and at the same time at P here, negative charge particle deficiency is here. So it means this arm will be end will be positively charged and this end will be negatively. Means at the end of the conductor PQ, potential difference is now created, and due to this potential difference some EMF will be created here, and that EMF you can calculate easily by the help of this electric field E. So now let's put here values that we have obtained. Here one more thing, if you will see theta. So theta is angle between this velocity vector and magnetic field. So velocity vector is in this direction, magnetic field is in this. So clearly you can see here theta is 90. So sine 90, if you will write, its value will be 1. Now you can put Fm is equal to QVB and Fe is equal to QE from here. So finally we can obtain E is equal to V into B from all this concept. Now as E is equal to V into B, then you know that the this electric field due to this one, we are obtaining some potential over the length L. So this potential relationship we can write down by E by L, this is equal to VB. So this is the induced EMF or potential that is generated at the end of the conductor. So finally E will be equal to VLV here. So this is our derivation for the induced EMF. Now for current, if you have to find out the current in the loop, so current in the loop will be equal to induced EMF per unit radius, resistance here. So as resistance is given our question, that is capital R. So E I will be equal to E by R from here. We can write VLV upon R. And as for other arms, resistance is negligible, so we cannot calculate current for them. So only for PQ arm we can calculate current, and that current will also flow in entire loop there. So only due to the PQ arm here in the current we will get, not due to any other arm. So that's why we are getting only one current here, and this current will move in the loop. So here the first question is asked, that is the current in the loop. So this will be the answer for the current in the loop here. Now the first question that we have solved here. Second question we have to solve for the force that is experienced by this loop here. So as for the force, again we will come to the concept of the here Lorentz concept. Then you know that according to the Lorentz concept, for any moving conductor we are obtaining the Lorentz force by the formula, that is F is equal to IBL sine theta. So here theta, clearly I've told you already, that is 90 degree, because the current element is in the opposite direction to the movement of the electrons. So if in the movement of the electrons you will see in opposite direction the current element, again magnetic field is perpendicular to this one, so that's why it will be 1. And here you can write down the value of R from here. So if you will put the value of R, this is BLV upon R, this is BL, and finally you can obtain this is B square L square V upon R. So this is our answer for the force here. Third question in the same here, the power required to move the arm PQ. So here if we have to calculate the power then we can calculate it by several methods. So here, as mechanical power, you know that is given by force into velocity through which it is moving here. So we know we need the mechanical power to move the arm here. So we can calculate it by this formula. So here F, that just now we calculated, this is V square L square V upon R, and if you will multiply V here, so finally you will get V square L square V square upon R. So this is the power needed to move the arm PQ. So this derivation, I think that is now clear. So students, next question we have, that is a rectangular coil of 200 tons of wire 15 cm cross 40 cm makes 50 revolution per second. So and about an axis perpendicular to the magnetic field of 0.08 Weber per meter square. So what is the instantaneous value of induced EMF when the plane of the coil makes an angle with the magnetic field lines? First is given 0 degree, second is given 60 degree. So let's just find out the answers for this question, then first summarize the data again. So for the data, it is given a rectangular coil we have that has number of turns, this is 200. Second thing is given, the area of the loop is given. The dimension is given, that is 15 cross 40 centimeter square. So here if you will convert it in meter square and if multiply it, then it will be finally obtained to 6 into 10 power minus 2 meter square here. Next thing is given, that is magnetic field. So its value is given, that is 0.08 Weber per meter square. And last one value is given, it is making the rotation 50 revolution per second. Means here the concept of the or change in orientation and due to that induced EMF and current we were getting, we are going to utilize that one. So here as omega, you know that is given by 2 pi f here, and f is given 50. So we can write down this value. So this will be equal to 100 pi radian per second. Next here as now you know that whenever we are changing the orientation of the coil, then due to that induced EMF is produced, and this induced EMF has value NAB omega sine omega t. This is the formula for us. Now we have to find out the first question. This is given, when plane of the coil is making angle with the magnetic field lines 0 degree. So as the first question, that is if we will have this rectangular coil, its plane is making the angle with magnetic field lines 0 degree, it means that the magnetic field lines is in this direction because the plane is in this direction. Clear? And you know that the area vector that we are drawing for this angle calculation between B and A, this area vector is normal to the loop. So it means that the angle between magnetic field lines and area vector is here 90 degree. So for this, the omega t will have the value again 90 degree. So if you will write down this value, then for the first condition when it is given that we have theta is equal to 0, so for which if you will find out the angle omega t, this will be equal to here 90 degrees. And for the simplification, if you want to understand, you can write down some alpha, that is equal to omega t minus theta. So whenever you will apply this formula, you can calculate easily what will be the value of this induced EMF. So here for the first case, theta is 0 is given. So we can find out the alpha here. So alpha is equal to not omega t here, 90 minus theta you have to write. So alpha is equal to, we have 90. And just now I have told you why we are getting the 90 here. So let's put the value of 90, sine 90 is 1, and finally E is obtained to be NAB omega. Now if you will put the value of N, this is 200, value of E, this is 6 into 10 power minus 2 we have, value of B here given 0.08, and value of omega, that is 100 pi. And if you will solve all these values and after putting the value of pi, so the answer is obtained to be 301.6 volt. So this is the induced EMF for the first case when the theta is 0 here given. For the second case it is given, the plane of the coil is making angle with magnetic field lines 60 degree. So it is given that the theta is 60, then the alpha will obtain, that is equal to 90 minus 60 means 30 degree. So if you will write down in this formula, the value of omega t, this is equal to 90 minus theta here, and here this value, it means that sine 30, if you will write, then sine 30 will have the value 1/2, and this value we have calculated already. So directly in this case we can calculate the answer. So this is equal to 301.6 upon 2 here. So after the solution, the answer is 150.8 volt. So this is the answer for us. So such kind of questions you will always encounter with, and you have to just solve it by the simple theoretical observations, theoretical formula, by data writing here, and by the correct formula options there. So let's just end our session here for today, and in next class we will just start the new chapter AC circuits. So just end our series. Thank you.